Hi, thank you for joining me today as we go over passive drool collections. You will need a few items for your passive drool collection, including a collection tube, saliva collection aid or a straw depending on what you were given, an alcohol swab to wipe your tube down with, water to rinse your mouth out with, and a container to put your sample into while it's stored in the freezer, such as a plastic bag or a box. At least 10 minutes prior to collecting your saliva sample, you'll want to rinse your mouth out with water. You'll swish water around your mouth and swallow or spit it out into a sink or cup, depending on your preference. This will help remove any large food particles and prevent them from getting into your saliva sample. You do not want to eat or drink anything prior to collecting your sample again. Once you're ready to collect your sample, you want to make sure to select the right tube to collect into. If they've been barcoded, that will help you make your selection. If they haven't been barcoded, you've probably been given barcoded labels. You'll select the correct label and place it over your tube onto this white patch, being sure that the barcode is running lengthwise on the tube and that it's not covering over the volume markers on the other side of the tube. After that, you can uncap your tube and place the cap up on the countertop. You can then take your straw and put it into the tube, or if you're using a saliva collection aid, take it out of the foil package and place it into the tube so that the end with ridges goes into the tube and that the smooth end goes out of the tube. At this point, you want saliva to start collecting into the bottom of your mouth. If you have trouble collecting, you can make gentle chewing motions or think about your favorite foods or think about salty or sour foods, which can help saliva production. Once you feel saliva collecting into the bottom of your mouth, you want to resist swallowing and instead gently guide the saliva into the tube through the straw. Be careful not to blow the saliva into the tube too hard or it could bubble or overflow from the tube. Once you've collected the desired amount, you want to remove the straw or saliva collection aid and throw that into the trash. You then can recap your tube, take your alcohol swab, and wipe down the outside of the tube to remove any saliva. You can then place your tube into your plastic bag or box and place this immediately into a freezer. You can then go wash your hands thoroughly. Thank you for joining me today for passive drool collections. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to your study contact or email us at iisbr@uci.edu. Thank you.